How's it going, everybody? John McLennan here, and in today's video, I'm going to teach you how to play Working Man as recorded by Otis Rush on guitar. This is a funky blues in the key of D. We're going to start off with this classic intro that begins on the last four bars of our 12-bar blues, and then we're going to jump into a 12-bar blues chord progression, which is something that I talk a lot about here on the channel. And before we dive into it, I want to hook you up with something right away. At the first link down below, I've got a free blues guitar training series. And if you want to build a solid foundation with your blues guitar playing, check this out. These are some exclusive videos that are not on YouTube, and they come with multiple camera angles and PDF downloads for each lesson that you can get completely for free. So check that out as my gift to you. And with that said, let's break down this song. Let's break down how to play Working Man as recorded by Otis Rush on guitar. Now, the intro starts with what we call the turnaround, and this is a blues in the key of D. Here's how it starts off. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we're into our 12-bar blues there. So I'm going to be playing some standard kind of blues bar chords here. We're going to start off on an A7 at the 5th fret, and that's 5-7, 5-6-5-5. So that's our first chord there. Then we're going to shift to a C7 chord on the 3rd fret here, 3-5-3-5-3. And then we're going to come up to a G7, which is the same as our A7, just on the 3rd fret. And then we're going to go to a D7, which is the same as the C7, but on the 5th fret. So that's going to be counted like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And so we have some chord anticipation here. This A is on beat 1. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And that C7 comes on the and of 4. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And 1 and 2. And then on beat 3 here for the G7. And then the and of 4 for the D7. So all together, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And 1 and... Then again, another hit on the and of 4. Then we do this little chromatic walk-in where we go. We're into our 12-bar blues. Okay, that's one time through our 12-bar blues progression there. So what I did was I walked in to that D7, and this is a very common blues sound. Your target is this D chord, but you're playing a half step below, and then you move into it like this. And rhythmically, that chord is a C-sharp 7. It's landing on the and of 4. So we're going to go 4 and 1. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... Then we're going to play 4 bars of our 1 chord here, D7. And I'm going to accent the backbeat. So that's going to be 2 and 4 like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And so I'm kind of playing like a muted strum here, 8th notes, like 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And but on beats 2 and 4, I'm hitting the higher strings with this staccato strum. So I'm just kind of muting out the strings like that. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Now on the and of 4 there, we're gonna shift to walk into the 4 chord. And you keep hearing this on the recording where it's sort of approaching each chord there from a half step below. So coming out of the intro, we're gonna play this. 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 4. Here comes the half step. So what I played there was an F sharp 7 to a G7, which again is like that chord we used at the beginning, just on fret 2, and then moving up to 3. 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Then we return back C sharp 7 to D7 on the and of 4 to 1. 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So if I play the pickup into the first 8 bars of this 12-bar blues, it sounds like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Okay, then we get to the last 4 bars of our 12-bar blues, and this is basically going to be the intro progression, but we're going to change the rhythm just slightly. We're going to play. Okay, so what I played here was a whole note on A7, 1, 2, 3, 4, then a half note on C7, and a half note on G7. So that would be like this. 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and. Then we return back to that D7 groove. We're going to play 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1. And then we restart. So again, back to that top with the C sharp 7. Into the D7. So when we come to that D7 after the A7, C7, G7, like this, 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and C7, G7, then we're back to the groove, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1. So again, I'm emphasizing that backbeat, and I'm going to listen for that drummer. They're going to be playing the snare on that 2 and 4, and I'm just going to lock right in with that snare drum hit. So the last 4 bars go like this, 1, 2 and 3 and 4 and 2 and 3 and 4 and we're back to the top. Now sometimes in the recording there'll be this little variation where you'll add in a C sharp 7 before the D7 like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and again, you could always kind of approach from a half step below, and that's just a fun part to add in there. So I'm going to put all 12 bars together here of our main progression, as so you can just hear it as one piece. Here we go. 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and alright, so let's put this together with our intro, and then we'll end with hitting that D7. Here we go. 1 and 2 and intro. 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 12 bar blues. A7, C7, G7, D7. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Now, after you play that for the entire song, so you do the intro, then you just stay on that 12-bar blues for the entire song until the very last time. The very last time, you just stay on D7. And the song just vamps and fades out on that D7 backbeat groove. 1 and 2 and three, and four, and... Have fun practicing Working Man as recorded by Otis Rush on guitar. I hope you got some value out of today's video. Before you go, don't forget to download my free blues guitar training at the first link down below. Again, if you get value out of my lessons here on YouTube, you're gonna get so much more out of these exclusive videos that come with tab downloads and everything you need to make the lesson as effective as possible. Also, if you want to dive deeper with guitar, check out my website, johnmclennan.com. I've got a lot of great resources on there as well. As always, leave your song requests down below. Let me know what you thought of this video, what you'd like to see me teach here next on the channel. Thanks for your support, and we'll see you in the next video.